So when I go back and I talk about these players and the top five players who not only built up organizations or helped continue the organization's tradition, a la Kobe, I go back and I ask myself, what has LeBron did to build up any organization from the ground?
What does that have to do with being one of the greatest of all time?
But that thing, when we talk about these great players, that the name the players that I said, they're all top flight players in the top five or top 10. Bill Russell built up the organization in Boston. Should get way more credit than we give him. And a lot of times he gets left out the conversation. So in saying that, Kareem, look at the names that I said. Kareem, Magic, Jordan, Tim Duncan, Kobe, Bird. These guys are all top 10 players who would either help build up their organization or continue the tradition.
And in saying the one thing that has ever...
From LeBron. He went and put together a team in Miami.
I think there's a lot of...
He came back to Cleveland to put that team together. And then he went to the Lakers, where a tradition has already been made, and we don't know, you know, that's still to be continued. So in saying that, that's my argument.
Who's the best wing shooter of all time?
The best wing shooter of all time? Ooh. Right now, it's Ray Allen, but it will be Steph.
It will be Steph.
He's not a wing, though.
Wait.
What is Steph?
He's a point guard.
He's a wing guy.
What?
What's
he's a wing guy.
Now?
He's a combo guard. That's not a point guard.
Get the show over with,
he's
man.
He's a wing guy. But Ray Allen, he's
so
the best
Steph Curry is not
time.
A. He's a wing guy.
Yeah, he just.
What plays, is a wing guy?
He just. Plays
I like
the
it.
Point.
Wing guy.
He's a combo.
He's a hybrid.
And then Clay.
Okay, those so
Clay
right
is,
now it's Clay. Then it's gonna be Steph.
Then it's gonna be Steph. Then
it's Clay. Gonna be Clay. Wow, that's a weird chart. Okay.
Well, the numbers are gonna speak. When it's all said and done.
Would you get the segment over with?
No, I have some numbers here, Paul. You're eighth all-time in three-pointers made, Clay 18th. You'd scored over 2,600 more points over the same span as Clay's career. So I ask you, is Clay a better wing shooter than you were in your prime?
But you're asking Paul.
What? Is he a better?
Wing shooter. It's okay. You can say yeah.
I'm going to say no. Because this is why. In clutch situations.
Why are you staring at me like that?
It was money in the bank. You haven't seen Clay in these situations quite a bit.
You want
they
me
don't
tell
go
you this,
to him.
You want me to tell you what it is?
Yeah, go ahead.
I mean, you got Clay. If you got Clay down the stretch and you got me down the stretch, who you want shooting that three?
Oof. Now that I know you?
I'm telling you, listen.
Come on.
Paul Pierce.
Come on.
It's tricky. It's tricky. Come
on, was a better wing scorer.
Okay. Oh.
And I would say he's a better player than Clay.
Okay.
But just shooter
is on the line, and you got the shot for three. Who you want taking it, me or him?
Wide open, I'm taking Clay.
Come on.
Wide open, I'm taking Clay.
Okay, wait. Both NBA Finals MVP. You have him in career points. He's got more playoff points. You are a more clutch shooter overall. He's got more playoff points. Paul, riddle me this. Who's the better NBA player?
That's easy. I can say that off the bat. That's me. If you give me Shaq. If you give me LeBron,
they did on the big three.
We got that late, but like early in my career.
What are you
if
doing
If you give
right
me
now?
These guys early in my career.
Ask you this. What would have been a perfect time for you, Paul? Let's make sure we get this
when
right.
I was 24 years old, okay. You give me Shaq. When I'm 24, 25, you give me LeBron and Bosh. I'd be sitting on five or six championships, easy.
So then who has the better NBA career?
I played 10 years, years with who?
You know what?
With who?
Antoine Walker. But here's the thing.
Come on, man. Giannis definitely has to play better, but as a team, I don't know where Milwaukee goes from here. Because
what are you
whoa. Oh, so listen. Is this over?
No, listen. I think it's over.
This series is over.
Yeah, they
one
lost.
One game? You just said it and said that they could win an NBA championship.
Yeah, I did say that. But
one game.
I think styles make fights in boxing.
We know the style of both teams before the series started.
Yeah, but it just seemed like Milwaukee was the way better team throughout the regular season. But when I watched this today, if Giannis doesn't have a monster game and somebody else besides him doesn't step up, Boston is just going to out-talent them. Because when you look down the line, even if Kyrie Irving doesn't have a great game, Tatum, he didn't play too well today. He can step up big the next game. So it's like as a Milwaukee, as a coaching staff, do I say, okay, do we focus our concentration on Kyrie? Because now Tatum can step up. Guys like Marcus Morris can step up. Terry Rozier. And that's why the Celtics, are dangerous. They just have more. They have more talent than the Milwaukee Bucks. That's vicious. Yeah, yeah, he got it. He got it. I thought my step back was vicious, but his.
Oh, here we go with the Paul Pierce.
Hold on.
Your step back was nice.
If we're going to keep it real,
the reason
you see all these kids doing the step back is because I pioneered it.
Oh, my goodness.
I almost want y'all to stop.
So you created the step back?
No, I just made it famous.
Your step
somebody
back,
did it
first of all, your
somebody
step back.
Somebody did it first. I made it better.
Can we get some tape on this? The step back pump fake was a travel every time.
No, I made the step
was
back.
Was it a travel?
Here we go against New Orleans.
I traveled a lot, yeah. But so do James Harden. Where do you think he got it from?
Did you
now it's James. Oh, my goodness. This guy.
You know what? I think we get to see that for 1 second. I don't even know what's happening.
So are we going to show every step back of the season?
It's every single one.
We're going to put the whole
in fairness to everyone, we didn't
people want to hear us talk. They want to see us. We're going to see him tonight during the game, man. Cut this out, man.
In fairness, we didn't know Paul was going to claim ownership.
I'm the pioneer.
He founded the step
back. I pioneered the step back.
So, like, when people was talking about Tim Hardaway's killer crossover and Chris Jackson and Mark Moore's crossover,
you got the Kareem
hook. It was Paul Pierce on the step back.
You got the Kareem hook, the Jordan fadeaway, the Euro step from Ginobili, the Paul Pierce step back.
This is your chance, because I don't know what he's going to pick.
Look at him,
Paul? Who do you
look at
pick?
If you want somebody to slow down James Harden, it's not going to be Clay. He's a good defender, but he don't have
the
length.
He's a great defender.
He don't have the length, the quickness for Harden. I mean, it's got to be a guy like the Greek Freak.
Here we go.
The athleticism, the long arms. He can recover. The smarts.
Oh, my goodness.
Come on. He can cover ground if you get by him. I mean, that's the perfect prototype.
Giannis.
Giannis, I just saw Giannis was just guarding Gobert the other night. He ain't going to be out there trying to guard
I'm
James
saying,
for no
saying,
whole
we
game.
I'm saying,
you got to cut it out,
slow down, James Harden.
He laughed at mine.
Please stop it.
This is who I want,
you
Marty.
Literally laughed
you go
at
to a
Clay.
Step, you want a step Harden. Back. You got a seven-footer with
he
athleticism.
He starts at the four.
If you go by him, he can meet him at the rim.
Man, if you don't cut it out.
If he goes by.
Matter of fact, somebody get some tissues. I'm just sweating.
I cannot
because of the trash that he's talking about.
These guys know.
Okay,
this is unreal.